call to the astronauts on board Space Shuttle Atlantis signaled the beginning of their day to rendezvous and dock with the International Space Station. While the ISS crew members prepared their vehicle for docking, Shuttle Commander Ken Cockrell and Pilot Mark Polanski configured systems on the flight deck of Atlantis. As the shuttle continued to close in on the station, Cockrell moved to the aft flight deck to take manual control of his ship as it neared a point directly below the station. With the station crew monitoring from inside the Zvezda module, Cockrell pulsed the orbiter's thrusters to push Atlantis toward ISS. At a range of 500 feet, Cockrell maneuvered the shuttle to turn its tail into the direction of travel, and then resume the slow, methodical approach to the station's pressurized mating adapter number 3. Atlantis continued to push in slowly, bringing their cargo, the U.S. Destiny Laboratory. At 30 feet, Cockrell sent word that all was ready.
We don't see a flyout, and everything on board Atlantis is ready for docking. We're going to press on in.
Copy, Taco. Thanks for the update. We concur.
Alpha Atlantis, here we come.
Cockrell pulsed the orbiter's thrusters, and the station was commanded to free drift to prevent inadvertent jet firings. As the vehicles crossed to the northeast of New Guinea, Atlantis crept closer and then docked with the station. Leak and pressure checks between the two vessels were completed, the hatches were opened, and the shuttle crew floated in to greet their counterparts on the ISS. After their greeting, the crew got to work transferring equipment to the space station. In the station's Zvezda service module, Expedition 1 crew members Sergei Krikalov and Yuri Gidzenko set up a backup command and control computer delivered by Atlantis. Polanski, the in-cabin spacewalk choreographer, reviewed the plans for tomorrow with spacewalkers Tom Jones and Bob Kirby. After completing today's first batch of transfer items and doing initial setups, the crews returned to their home vehicles and closed the hatches. The shuttle crew then lowered their air pressure to prepare for tomorrow's first spacewalk to attach the Destiny Laboratory to the International Space Station.
You would enjoy hearing that piece, and I'm sure your former dog mates would agree with that.
Well, thank you very much, Ellen. Pass on to Nate that I appreciate that. Most of us were pretty much speechless when the music came on.
Mission Specialist Tom Jones on the left, Commander Ken Cockrell in the center of the view in his commander's seat, and in the lower right, Pilot Mark Polanski. That was the final minor rendezvous maneuver, the next major targeting maneuver, the terminal initiation burn, 54 minutes away. That burn will come with Atlantis only about 9 miles behind the International Space Station as it prepares for that final targeting burn in preparation for the rendezvous and docking scheduled for 10:50 this morning, Central Time, 11:50 a.m. Eastern Time. Tom Jones, one of the three spacewalkers.
Box 22 Alpha. Careful, Tom. Look out.
No updates to 22 Alpha.
pilot Mark Polansky on his first voyage into space. Just a moment ago, we saw Marsha Ivins, who's the flight engineer aboard Atlantis, and Tom Jones, who will be one of the two spacewalkers during the three spacewalks that will begin tomorrow after the shuttle has docked with the station. And the other spacewalker, Bob Kerbeam, coming into view from the middeck.
Now everybody's present and accounted for.
Хорошо, вот рядом сидит Василий Васильевич Цыплеев. Хочет вас поприветствовать.
О, Василий, привет.
А, привет, Сережа. Юра тоже на ушах?
А сейчас там га. Нет, по-моему, без ушей пока.
Хорошо, Юр, ну, тебе от мужиков привет. Наше поздравление со стыковкой. И дай бог, чтобы дальше работа продолжалась также в этом плане.
А, спасибо.
Мы когда садите, потом обговорим.
Ладно.
Ну, мы там вас будем встречать.
Ты тоже там будешь, да?
Буду. Должен быть там.
Ну, отлично.
Так, у нас все в порядке. Все идет по плану. Как говорится, но плана нет.
Ну, это нормальный ход.
Так должно быть, иначе так неинтересно.
Конечно. Как телевидение у вас идет?
Отличная картинка, великолепная просто.
Видишь, мы специально заснять, проверить, что там лэп есть, видишь.
Подтверждаем, лэп есть. Аж птичка красивая во весь экран. А, Сереж, если есть какие-то вопросы или пожелания, я готов выслушать. И там потом на совещании проработаем.
Алло, Вася.
А, Юр, привет, дорогой.
Ага, привет, расслышу тебя.
Да, Юр, тебе...
Отлично, хорошо, спасибо. Ты там прочитал, да, мою маляву?
Да, маляву-халяву прочитал, да, спасибо.
Ну, ладненько.
Ну, ладно, вы работаете, я отвлекать вас не буду. Спасибо. И до встречи.
Спасибо, Вася.
Я потом еще постараюсь на сеанс приходить, потому что времени мало сейчас.
Хорошо. Привет всем тоже, Вася.
Хорошо, спасибо.
Передавай там привет всем.
Хорошо. Удачи вам, мужики.
The first pair of U.S. solar arrays stretching 240 feet tip to tip, clearly visible as color orange in this view. As the shuttle and station pass high above the southern tip of South America in the next 2 minutes or so. Continuing to take still sequential images through the centerline camera in the orbiter docking system. We don't have a direct KU band antenna link as Atlantis approaches the 600-foot point almost directly beneath the station now. And now we have live television from Atlantis. At a range of 240 feet from the International Space Station, docking 36 minutes away. At 140 feet beneath the station now, crew's been given a go for docking again. The approach will continue down to 30 feet. There may or may not be a station keeping position at that distance, but at this point all is going very smoothly. Atlantis creeping in at a very slow 1/10 of a foot per second closing rate. Very smooth, deliberate approach, approaching 35 feet now. This is the point at which Commander Ken Cock will make a decision as to whether the proper alignment is seen between the orbiter docking system and the station's docking port. If he's comfortable with that alignment, there will be no need for a station keeping at 30 feet. He can press on through to docking. He's already been given a go for docking by both flight control teams.
25, 35 feet. We don't see a flyout, and everything on board Atlantis is ready for docking. We're going to press on in.
Copy, Taco. Thanks for the update. We concur.
Alpha Atlantis, here we come.
Two meters now, about 6 feet from contact. Standing by for confirmation of initial contact and capture. Contact and capture confirmed.
Alpha Atlantis, we show you in free drift with blinking ACS motoring lights.
Atlantis, Houston, station free drift confirmed.
Thanks, Mario, and capture confirmed.
Send it carrier mode.
Atlantis, Houston, great job, guys, on a smooth approach and docking. It's nice to have Destiny closer to home there. At this time, we'll take A-12 and B-12. Rate damping will be per the cue card, and just a reminder to load the maneuver before going to auto.
Okay, Mario, got all that. Houston, Atlantic, Max is ready. I'd like to do docking mechanisms power down now.
And Atlantis's payload bay housing the U.S. laboratory Destiny, soon to become a permanent fixture on the International Space Station. Commander Ken Cockrell and Mission Specialist Tom Jones are preparing to open the hatch. The hatch is on the other side, already open, as we heard from Space Station Commander Bill Shepard. Hatch is opened at 1:03 p.m. Central Time, 2:03 this afternoon Eastern Time.
And Atlantis Alpha Houston, we have video from the service module. And greetings to Shep and Yuri and Sergey.
Aboard the International Space Station's Zvezda module, Tom Jones in the yellow shirt moving off in the distance. Two Russian cosmonauts as part of the Expedition 1 crew. Yuri Gadzinko, the pilot on board, and Sergei Krikalev, flight engineer.